The old Dublin Cinderella. I'd like to tell you all a tale about poor old Dublin Cinderella. It was forced to stay at home, and so she never had a bella. She never got. She never had a bella. She spent all day just cleaning, washing, scrubbing floors. Her day was never ending, for she had so many chores. She lived with her evil stepmom and two very ugly sisters who were obese and spotty, with leathery skin and full of blisters. Cinderella wasn't happy, and the sisters, well, they knew, for she was very, very lonely. Friends, well, she had none. And then two ugly sisters, well, they had all the fun. The prince was in his palace, and he thought,
I lead a lonely life.
I throw a ball for one and all, and I'll find myself a wife.
Their sisters came home one day, ever so excited. A prince was holding a fancy ball. They were ever so delighted. What were they?
Delilah
and Delilah.
Here.
Well, those awful ugly sisters kept sisters working day and night to make them look presentable and not such an awful fright. Ugly sisters, the evening of the ball arrived. The stepmom was filled with glee. Why, my daughter looks so beautiful. A mother-in-law I'll be. Poor Cinder stood there all alone and watched them go their way. Her heart was slowly breaking, and she began to pray.
Oh,
I am your fair godmother, and this you need to know.
Abby, hey,
I'm here to protect you and off the ball you two go.
Looking
splendid with one
maid
of my magic wand.
She waved her wand, and with a boom, fairy dust filled all the room. Cinderella looked a beautiful sight, would make any young man's beating heart pump with joy and delight. Cinderella's heart was thumping.
Right.
check, Katie.
By the time they get to Dublin City, we'll never get to play Dublin Castle. Come on, sweetheart.
Doorway she did see, bouncers handling drunken fights, She knew. She tapped it, eh? So, next morning, on the garden steps, a glass slipper it was found. It was brought to Prince Charming, who said,
"We mustn't hang around. The girl who owns this slipper, forget her I cannot. I need her in my life. I'll make her my wife."
She called the security guard that was in her employ.
Yes.
Go and find the girl that fits this second slipper. When you find her, tell her I'll meet her in Fishamble Street outside the Burdock's chipper.
Himself and the security guard went knocking on all doors. Out and out! Their feet were bloody sore. They saw so many smelly feet, but in drove snowmail, blisters, and some of them smelly feet, well, they looked like they were growing horns. They reached Cinderella's place, which happened to be that place called Face. What place was it?
Face!
And them two ugly sisters, they both were filled with tears. Because between the two of them,
mine,
they prayed.
Mine!
The ugly sisters' feet were huge and all distorted. The prince and the security guard, and by the cold day which they started. They squeezed their feet into the slipper, and the slipper nearly broke. Prince Charming was shocked and horrified. She nearly had a stroke.
Give me back that slipper, you dirty pair of wasters. I've had enough this quest, this talk. I'll never find me missing. Come on, you.
Prince Charming then pocketed Cinderella, who was busy.